everyone, Ian Van Tile here, and behind me is a 2017 Cruiser Yachts 390. So let me show you some of the special features and benefits that this motor yacht has to offer. All right, so here we are looking at the profile of the 2017 Cruiser Yachts 390 Express Cruiser. And as you can see, it has a stunning design features about it. It's just really ahead of its time with packed full of innovation. And I'm gonna go through some of those features with you. But what I really love about it is just its overall design, how it brings the natural light in. You have lots of window, integrated in with its whole design. So when you're sitting down below, you really get to experience all the elements. Not to mention its cutting technology hull design. As we're looking out the bow here, due to the dock space, they had to move the anchor up forward, but you have a nice anchor roller up forward, allows you to have easy access. You can see the angle of the hull entry is quite nice, so you don't have to worry about smacking the hull while you're anchoring, bringing it up. You also have access to the anchor locker, which is right here. This lifts up. You have the, up and down foot switches. We also have a opening cabin top hatch there to allow ventilation through the boat. But as you can see, as we walk back down, the hull is shiny. The owner keeps this boat in immaculate condition. And later this month, it's actually scheduled for the services that are coming due, not even due yet, but coming due. We just wanna make sure that this is in, really good condition for the next owner. But again, when you look at the styling and its design, I left the kind of somewhat enclosure part here, but it's very well thought out. And as we come to the transom of the vessel, again, what I like is just the engineering that was just thought. These are retractable cleats, so you can keep them down here when you're using them for your fenders. We have a really nice, convenient swim step platform here off the back of the transom. And as we step on board, you can see just how well this has been integrated. So you're gonna see from the Cruiser Yachts videos that this seating arrangement can be configured in many different ways. We have storage underneath both of these lockers here, but this whole seating arrangement can actually slide in and create U-shaped seating around the cockpit table. You can also have access here to the port side of the vessel. There is a swim step shower that's right here, conveniently located. Again, as I mentioned, we have storage bins here, wash down, our shore power inlet. There's even really nice integrated stainless steel kind of little doors here to kind of close off the cockpit so if you have small kids or animals. And again, the seating arrangements have multiple different uses. Not only is there storage packed in here, but the backrests kind of lift up and it truly is a transformable boat. Down below this synthetic teak cockpit flooring is engine room access. And as we look up forward, you can see just how you can completely enclose this cockpit area, this forward cockpit. It's also integrated with a nice isotherm refrigerator here. Just aft of this, this lifts up and you have this nice wet bar and then also a electric Kenyan grill under here. So really convenient, nicely thought of. And I like how they're able to enclose this section here. You also have heating and air conditioning vents to this back area. So if you do enclose the back, this is also accessible from that. These switches here are courtesy lights, spreader lights, your engine room access, underwater lights, your port and starboard bed. So again, this transforms the backrest here. So it lays down, lifts back up. And again, this boat is nothing but a transformer. I really, really find its innovation quite pleasing. As we walk up forward, nice large side decks here. We have a convertible soft top here. This will fully retract, allowing you to have full sun, just flooding that forward cockpit area. And then I left this on so you can see, but this is a lounge pad up here, but the owner's done a nice job of protecting it with this cover. So not only does it protect, the sun lounge area, which is a really nice two-tone material. You have the cup holders here, the backrests lift up, And again, I'll show you from some of the pictures, but it's just a great use of space, and it's easy accessible up here. I find it to be safe. You have really tall lifelines. And again, I really find that area quite nice. So accessibility into our anchor locker. We have a wash down here, a quick windlass anchor locker below that. Navigation lights. We have a forward, spotlight here as well too. But just look at the profile, just really cool. And as I mentioned, if you have kids or just anybody in the family, the accessibility to be able to walk up to the forward, bow and have this, features of the safety rails being high, lighting. It's really impressive. And I like this design feature with the hard top, how you have a nice integration right into the aft cockpit. Atop, we have a digital TV antenna. We have that full beam radar, GPS antenna, VHF antenna. And as we walk down into the aft cockpit here, again, you can see the seating with the electronic, adjustable backrest that lay out flat. And again, here's the locking pin. So you lift up this locking pin, and this whole thing just slides over. Integrates that U-shaped seating around the cockpit table, and then allows you to have access through here if you so desire. And there's even a stainless steel entry lock out there. So great use of space, very innovative. And as you can see, just doing this with one hand, it's designed quite nicely, has really nice rails on it. And then this just locks back into place. All right, so let's move forward into the forward cockpit. We have this really nice, I want to call it almost a J style, seating here. But, what I like about it is you can face forward, has a tall backrest, the quality, the construction of just how they've really designed this is quite nice. I love the stitching, in the seats, the integrated cup holders, the speakers. What I also like is you have a two-person forward-facing helm seat. So it's nice to be able to have somebody sitting right next to you as well, too. And again, this is pretty impressive. There is a footstool down below here that'll slide down and lock into place. And then that gives you that footing you need as you're kind of coming up here. You also have a bolstering, that lifts up. So if you are standing, and depending on, the type of plane that you're on, you can actually sit up here like so, change your visibility, and it's really impressive. Again, as I mentioned, this soft top just retracts back, so you get flooded with a lot of natural light here. You have this really high-end, helm wheel. I really dig it, just the feel, and it's, construction. It's been really impressive here. Air conditioning, heating vents. We have the Raymarine VHF. We also have a Ruhl water alarm. You have the fire suppression system here. You have a 12-volt outlet on the other side. Again, getting all to your wipers, battery, parallel switches, what have you. Our windlass breaker is located here. And then our ignition switches, quite nice. But that's an easy turn. You can see we only have 222 hours. 220 on starboard. We also have the access system here. So with the skyhook, autopilot controls, you have the full joystick docking. Again, for those of you who are new to boating, this is a really impressive feature. And what I love about this feature is that it is so easy to use, because when you're in the docking mode, you literally can push the boat sideways. By rotating it in this direction or in the opposite direction, you can turn the boat. So you just really have all the control you need from right here. So there's no necessary need for a bow thruster. Your IOs operate from this joystick and turn you sideways and get you into any direction that you want. And then to keep it simple, you have your throttle systems here. So forward, back, turn the boat. Again, this is a really nice system, and I love the orientation of how it's laid out, being able to access the joystick, the throttle systems. You also have your trim tabs here, your spotlight controller. This is the Raymarine hybrid touchscreen display. So this is your GPS plotter. This is also your radar, and really Nice feature behind that is that carbon fiber look. And this is the MerCruiser, you know, full engine display here. This is what's going to show us all of the readouts of our engines and what have you here. Really impressive. We also have a stereo remote switch here, and then lighting switches. This is the switch, you know, for the soft top to be able to open this up and close it. So again, when you're right here at the helm, it is very accessible to operate this boat single-handed. All right, well, let's go down below. But before we do that, again, look at the angled seating, this really cool, you know, design feature here, this large window that they've integrated. And again, the visibility on this is really superb. I mean, they've done a great job of being able to, you know, put you here at the helm, put your guests here, and you can really enjoy this space. Okay, enough setup here. Let's go down below. Three steps down into the companionway. Before we go down, we have our light switches. We also have our air conditioning heating remote. Look at this, really cool. I mean, look at this glass handle right here. That is really cool as you come down below. All right, looking down below and looking forward, I'll close this bedroom door, but we have our galley off to the port side. The galley is packed with another very large refrigerator capacity here. So this opens up, and again, you have shelving, small freezer capacity, but a good freezer storage. We also have the Kenyon two burner electric stovetop. We have the microwave oven here. And just look at this quality of craftsmanship. The woodwork is absolutely beautiful. I love these countertops. This is like almost a blue inlaid grain. Stainless steel sink. Really high-end fixtures here that they use. And look at this. Everywhere you go, you just feel like you're not missing out, that you're part of that ocean experience. This is also an impressive design. And what I love about it is you have these, you know, V-shaped seating here. There is a table that the previous owner removed just because he wanted this open, kind of more of a loungy experience. And he felt that the table got in the way, but the table base will mount down here. And you have a standard table, but these seats will also come out. There's filler cushions so that you can create two different berths up here as well too. Packed full of storage. You also have really nice pleated blinds that cover the windows, overhead storage, lots of compartments. You know, this beautiful overhead, you know, textured look here. And as you go up forward, again, just everything's packed, lots of storage, opening hatch here. We have, you know, screens on one side, shades on the other. And again, it's just a very comfortable boat to be in. So sitting here in the salon, again, you're looking out, you have great visibility all around you. You have an LG, you know, flat screen television here. We also have the Fusion stereo system. And then again, lots of cabinetry, lots of storage. And then everywhere you look, there's just lots, you know, of really cool lighting features that they've kind of really encompassed this area. Now, behind this door here, is our head. So head and full walk-in shower. So this is a Dometic electric freshwater flush toilet. We have our 110 outlets, our lighting switches here, that same beautiful countertop that they used in the galley. And then the previous owner had upgraded this sink. So this is a new vessel sink here and a real beautiful faucet. The mirrors behind that, there are storage here. And then again, take a look at this shower compartment. So plexiglass doors to encompass this area, but really nice fixtures here. You even have heating, air conditioning vent kind of blowing here, towel rack. But again, amazing amount of storage, you know, bench, you know, seating here. And, you know, also integrated kind of handhold here that operates that slide. Again, the floors, the woodwork, the flooring, I really find this to be quite impressive. This will lift up and you have access here to your holding tank, your bilge, but you can see just how clean it is down here. It is absolutely immaculate. Underneath the steps, we also have additional storage underneath here. And then let's go into the master cabin. So this opens up, locks into place with a magnet lock there. And then as we come in, you can see this first landing area. So we have our kind of our own lounge, air conditioning, heating controls, lighting switches, a huge hanging locker closet with a cedar inlay. But take a look at this bench, large bench. We also have, you know, accessibility, storage down there. We have this kind of countertop space, a large mirror here. This is our Glomex TV antenna remote. But take a look at this. I mean, for a boat of this size and all the features that it offers, I'm really impressed with its design. This opens up, large storage compartment here. Another small little, you know, kind of cabinet next to the bed. We have additional lighting switches, and this is our main electrical panels. So this opens up, we have our 12 volt, our 120, our distribution from our generator to ship to shore. And then again, all of our main switches from our battery chargers and what have you. Tank indication gauges for holding tank, water. And then you also have your start stop for your generator. So that's the blower. And then just push this and then your generator turns on. You'll flip the shore switches over, transfer it over. And then now the generator's powering all of your ship systems. So again, nicely done, very well set up here, and it's easy, it's convenient. I like that it's in the master cabin, so nobody else will mess with it. And then again, now we come to this mattress, large. I want to say Marine Queen or almost a king size berth here. It is quite large. We have this large Jensen flat screen television with its own DVD display down there. And, you know, good amount of headroom. So, I mean, it's a great cabin. You have the full beam here inside of the vessel, and really, really well designed. All right, so we covered a lot of boat in a short period of time. There is just so many features that it's really hard to pack into. I don't know how long we've gone on this video so far, but I hope I didn't bore you. And I hope I was able to kind of talk about, you know, what it really has to offer on this 390 Express Cruiser. If you would like more information about this boat, please feel free to contact myself, Ian Van Tile, at any time, day or night. I look forward to hearing from you and hopefully earning your business. If you liked the video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you haven't already, subscribe to my channel for additional video walkthroughs like this and find out what's coming on the market really before it even hits the MLS. Thank you again, and I look forward to hearing from you.